I work across the street from a hotel, and where I don't have a window where I work, but a couple of the other offices do. And I like to, from time to time, go look out the window because, it's always nice to see outside every once in a while during the day, right? So today I'm looking out and I'm looking at the hotel, the windows, and I see this man on the 12th floor, and I see this man on the 10th floor, bent over putting lotion on himself. And I'm like, is that guy naked? Sure enough, he was nude, standing in front of a window which at least was calf all the way up. I mean, you could see everything. Like, dude, what do you think? If you're gonna stand in front of a large window naked that nobody's gonna see you? Or maybe he doesn't care, I guess. But he had a nice body, so I suppose perhaps that was his objective, was to say hello to everyone. I don't know. I have to say, when I had a nicer body back in the day, before it all went wrong, I didn't mind if anybody saw my body. I mean, I would sunbathe topless, and I was house sitting for someone. I think I've talked about it before. And the pool guy came, which he was quite shaken up because he was like 80. I mean, he was an old man, and I'm not saying 80 in an exaggeration. He was really, really old, and I'm just out there, and I'm like, hey, I'm rocking it. I got a 20-something, age body, and gravity's my friend still, so, it was all good. Today, though, although I have to say, I do still sunbathe topless. Thankfully, I have a very high fence, and the gate is locked because it would not be all good. If you've seen the video before this one, you'll know that I went to see Big Tex being assembled, and he already was when I got there. So I was very sad about that. I had a few questions from people about Big Tex, his history. He originally was a Santa Claus back in the 50s in Kareen, Texas. Keren, Texas. I don't even know where that is. And he was sold to the fair, and they made him Big Tex in 1952. So he's 60 years old this year. So they're doing a big 60-year celebration for Big Tex. But he's had different heads over the years. He's changed. His arm was more outstretched. At one point, he looked like he had bug eyes. I'm not sure why that ever was okay. It was like that was the 60s. I think he's had this head for, I don't know, 20 some years now, I think. Maybe older, maybe longer, I don't know. But I think the thing I like about Big Tex the most is, well, he's still, even though his head is not from the 50s, he still has sort of a 50s vibe to him, and I really like that. And I love the mid-century stuff, so I'm drawn to that. And I don't know, not to say that going to the fair was always a highlight every year, but we did go when I was a kid. My mother didn't like going to the fair, so she never did. So my dad took us, and his mom, my grandmother, would come into town, and we would all go to the fair, except for my mother, partly because she hated my grandmother, but that's a whole other thing. So my mom would stay home. I'm sure she enjoyed the peace and quiet with four kids out of the house, and enjoyed the day. And we would go and come back loaded with crap that we won at the midway, and I don't know, riding the rides and all that. So, I have pretty good memories of the fair. That's the story. It's not a good one. I didn't say it was good. It's just a story. I've been in a video making mood lately, so that's why I'm making another one. I just am. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.